Well, the whistleblowing website WikiLeaks has started releasing over 5 million emails from Stratfor. Stratfor is a private intelligence gathering firm based in Texas. Their clients range from big corporations to government agencies. WikiLeaks reportedly obtained the emails from the hacktivist group Anonymous. Now, while there hasn't been anything particularly groundbreaking released yet, the documents do reveal several huge corporations working with the intelligence firm. Regardless of what details come out of the emails, they do reveal yet another layer of something we bring much attention to here at RT, the massive and profitable military-industrial complex. Well, to talk more about this, I'm joined now by Jason Burmes. He is the director of Invisible Empire, a new world order defined. Hi, Jason. So big companies turning to Stratfor for intelligence information. So obviously there is quite a demand for their services. Is intelligence yet another piece of the military-industrial complex?
Well, absolutely. It's part of this integral technopoly that we now have, not only in this country, but across the world. It shows you that corporations can now buy intelligence networks that are heavily involved with our own U.S. intelligence networks. In fact, even the mainstream media is dubbing them the shadow CIA. This is a firm that was created in 1996 by George Friedman. This man was a political analyst, political scientist. He'd spoken to DARPA, the U.S. Army War College, on many occasions, and essentially started this firm that is not only for hire, but has facilitated money laundering, paying informants overseas. Already we're seeing some of these emails leak, where Stratfor is trying to cover their behind because they know that they're involved in illegal activity overseas with many of these informants, and they say they don't want to do the perp walk.
And so obviously intelligence is a big business, as we are seeing from these leaked emails. It's a commodity, it seems, that now, you know, can be bought and sold. Who is benefiting from this business?
Well, just one of the names out there right now, again, it's very early, there are over 5 million emails to comb through, but people like Dow Chemicals that can not only spy on their competition, but also protesters. And again, it's business for hire without prosecution. It's having a middleman. It's having what the intelligence networks out there like the NSA and the CIA call plausible deniability, because again, they're doing it through these third-party services. So you can have a large corporation like Dow be able to gather intelligence on regular American citizens with really zero repercussions.
And who do you think should be most wary about these intelligence gathering agencies? In other words, who is most likely to be tracked and watched by these agencies?
Well, unfortunately, in many cases, it's people like you and me. When we oppose the system, when we oppose the establishment, when we do speak up at our city hall meetings, when we are involved in getting into the political process, where, for example, in upstate New York right now, they're trying to do a lot of fracking, and intelligence gathering on individuals who oppose them would be beneficial to these companies. And we're seeing this more and more today. And I think this is a great thing that these things have been exposed, because now the common man is going to be aware that big companies can purchase intelligence on you and your family, on other corporations, on their competition in unfair business practices.
And what about the argument that, you know, if there's nothing particularly incriminating or I guess criminal behavior that would catch the attention of law enforcement, why should the average citizen be concerned if they're like, hey, I have nothing to hide?
Well, look at the case of Julian Assange, for instance. These emails are already revealing that there's an indictment here, a secret indictment by the U.S. District Attorney's Office and the Department of Justice that nobody seems to be aware of. Why is it that this private corporation, Stratfor, is aware of it, yet the American people aren't? And how has this man been indicted when he hasn't even been extradited to this country and charged?
And Jason, what does it mean for average citizens' rights and privacy when we see these intelligence firms becoming growing businesses?
Well, again, it really puts the blame on somebody else. It allows, again, this technopoly to take larger hold of our lives. It allows us to be surveilled, tracked, traced, databased, and then that information sold to the highest bidder, where basically you can be profiled. And if you're doing something that isn't towards a certain corporation or entity's liking, that type of behavior is going to be squashed in a way that you may not even be aware of.
And do you expect the demand for this to increase?
I think this is just the beginning. Again, this is a firm that's out of 1996. Ever since this security state has grown, we've seen the launch of fusion centers across the nation. And really, this is par for the course. This is the norm in today's society, and really how intelligence is sold off to the highest bidder. We no longer have a constitutional republic run by the people and for the people, but we have this technopoly run by corporations and the military-industrial complex.
Very interesting. Jason, thank you for coming on the show. That was Jason Burmes, director of Invisible Empire, A New World Order Defined.